not doing that.
The hunting.
I started Yakuza 3 finally. Besides that, I'm trying to think. Let's see. Besides that, I've only been playing Destiny pretty much. That is basically it, I think. So, yeah. I mainly have the state of play today, so we finally have some dates on some games. Well, they finally put dates out for some games I was looking forward to, so I'm looking forward to them, but they're all, like, not anytime soon, so. So I'm just stuck waiting. I was kind of annoyed because I went to the store on the PS5 to see if they were up for pre-order, and they weren't, so I was like, well, hopefully they'll be up soon, so whatever. The Kena one, hold on, I'll look it up because I don't remember. I remember the, like, Final Fantasy VII Remake DLC thing. That was interesting, because they're giving you the game for free, you just have to get the DLC. Well, I mean, like, it's a free upgrade if you already have it on PS4, so I have to buy it again. But yeah, the DLC for that, just to play as Yuffie. And then Kena, Bridge of Spirits. I've been looking forward to that since, like, before PS5 came out, so if they finally have a release date, but it's in August, I think? Yeah, it's in August something something, so that's like the summer. That's pretty far away. Solar Ash looks interesting, but it didn't get a, like, month. It just got a date of 2021, so no idea when. And then Sifu looks interesting, and that's basically it. Because both of those didn't have, like, months, they just had 2021 in them, so it's like, no release date besides the year. What? No, they, like, why, that doesn't, no, because, like, a lot of the games that they showed were, like, PS4 and PS5, though. Or they're on both, so it doesn't, but it doesn't make, yeah, it doesn't make sense to hold back the console launch, because they can't even keep them in stock, so there's no point. The demand is there, so it's not like they need the games to sell them at this point anyway, because there's not really anything out that's like, oh man, this is such a great game to play on PS5, it's totally worth buying the console for. Or it's such a, like, you know, supply strain situation anyway, so it's such a, it's like you're just trying to get one. Noon-ish. I'm pretty sure there was a women's match on the pay-per-view. Yeah, because it was Brianna Banks and that hair lady, and against the other the champions. So why? What does the EST stand for? Like, does that stand for something? Okay. I'm like, what does EST even mean? Eighty-five. I was like annoyed because they were doing the interview with her on the thingy after the thing, but then it, like, the feed cut, and I was like, dang it, so I didn't get to see the whole thing. And then, like, okay, so last time I asked you about, like, the whole, like, division thing, except they, like, have so many, or just, like, confusing, kind of. Like, so, on, like, the belt thing, did they come up with a bunch of those belts recently? Like, the 24/7 one? Because I was like, that was not a thing before. So did they do that because so they can have like more like title defenses every show? Okay, I was wondering about that too. Like why there's like separate show titles. I don't know. So when do they go to Peacock? Okay. Fastlane. Roadblock. I was watching some YouTube video, because like after I started watching all those wrestling videos, it kept recommending a bunch of them, and so like I was watching this one about the WCW when it was like Hogan and Bischoff, and it was the like the part when like Ultimate Warrior came in, and then like they were saying that basically that Bischoff, like he was doing with WCW was like he wanted to have more pay-per-views so they could have more profitability that way, because that was kind of like the only way you could make more money is to have more pay-per-views. So they just like made up a bunch of pay-per-views. Yeah, I did look up the videos for that World War III thing. That was weird. The YouTube thing I was watching was someone that was doing like an analysis of it like after the fact, and then they're like at the time it was just like super chaotic and you didn't have enough camera angles to keep up with all the action like that was happening. Because they had like, yeah, 'cause they had three rings, and then like they didn't have enough camera angles or camera shots to like get all the angles of all the rings, so it was just like a chaotic scene. And he said like on the like second or third one they changed the rules to where it's like you didn't have to go over the top to be eliminated or something. I was trying to find the some like footage of like the war game stuff that I could like couldn't find any I wanted to watch. Or like I couldn't like I didn't see any of that like before clicking on them I knew the outcomes, so I didn't want to like watch it knowing who was gonna win beforehand. So I was like, eh. Have they changed the format of Elimination Chamber over time, or has it always been the same? Okay. Yeah, it is weird because like I remember back in the day they had like the weird blue steel cages, but now they have like the actual like chain link fencing on cages. Yeah, because I was watching, because I also watched like a couple super, or not super, but the, well, I did watch some. I keep forgetting the jeez. War game stuff, but it wasn't from the pay-per-view, because it was like ones that they did recently on NXT, and it was, because, so like, has it always been the same with that format, where it's like, the match doesn't start until everybody's in? Okay, I thought that was weird. I thought that was weird. Actually, the one I watched on NXT was pretty good because, like, they had like a bunch of hardcore stuff. They had like tables and stuff that they were like putting people through. I thought that was a pretty good match. Even like the women's match had like they're using chairs on each other and stuff. You been paying attention to the story at all as you've been playing this? Knew it. Well, the army you have on now is probably better than most of the armor that you could get because it's from Iceborne.
No, I don't. I might watch it. Still terrible. No, don't shoot a fire. Oh, also, I watched a, there was like one of the videos it recommended to me was like a Outside the Lines, which is a It was like an ESPN documentary series from like back in the day. It was on wrestling and I
Our
watched it. It
number
was pretty
one
funny.
priority is to secure the base by taking out that encroaching Anjanath.
It was like, let's see. I think the three issues were, let's see. The, just like the violence and sex that was in wrestling. And like the effects it has on like young kids watching it, that was one of them. And then another thing was like steroid use by wrestlers. And then another one was let's see, what's another one? There was like one more thing. Steroid thing. What else was there? Let's see, last thing, steroid thing. What else was there besides that? I think it just like what makes it so popular as well. But it was during the like the Raw Nitro Wars era, which was nice. And it was like talking to Hulk Hogan when he like became Hollywood Hulk Hogan and he was like a heel. And he was like, back when I was doing my old character, if I was doing that now, people wouldn't, or not that people wouldn't believe it, but like it wouldn't be, like nobody tells you to like say your prayers and eat your breakfast and all that stuff anymore. that was funny. And then it was like funny because there was like some interviews with like kids who were getting in trouble because they were like doing the suck it thing to their classmates. I thought that was great. Oh, I remember now. Okay, so the three things were, it was, like, the steroid abuse, the, like, physical, like, or, like, the just, like, the violent content, like, the sexual content of the shows, and, like, the effects on kids, but then also the, like, death of some wrestlers because of, I think it was steroids or painkillers or something. The monster ran away, and I think it's sleeping, so I'm gonna trap it. I didn't need you to capture both. What? It's not great, but it's not freezing cold. Okay, but so like, since they have the other titles as well, besides like the just show titles, those are still like defended every now and then, just like not all the time, right? Like the, cause like I saw like I was watching a bunch of videos about stuff, so it's like the Universal title, is that like a pretty new one? Cause I was like, that sounds like a weird name, and I was like, that must be a new one. Oh, okay. Huh. Okay, I was just curious if like. Oh, okay, I wasn't sure. Like, cause I was like, is that a new one? I was confused. Because I know that, because, like, yeah, because I was watching and I saw that they have, like, a US champion again. I was like, that was, like, I don't think that, I mean, I know that was a thing in WCW, but, like, I don't remember it being a thing in WWE for, like, when I was watching it back in the day. So I'm guessing they brought it back or something. So do they do the show defense ones pretty often, or is it once a month or something? Okay. Okay, that's what I was gonna ask. Yeah, 'cause I was watching, I started watching the clips of the recent shows, and I saw there was a thing between the Mysterios and Seth Rollins, and I was like, "What the F is going on?" But then I was like watching it, and it had suggested videos on the side, and I saw it was going on for a while, and I was like, "This is weird." Cause I was just trying to find matches of him and his son in a tag team match, but I couldn't find any. Oh, I was going to ask you, Buff. When did they come up with the concept of the money in the bank thing? So I thought that was pretty neat. Okay, 'cause I thought that was funny at the pay-per-view when Miz catches in when he was beating up on the person that already had already fought a match. Or no, the Elimination Chamber after the dude won and then he came out and beat him. I thought that was funny. Well, I thought that was what the neat part was, because it was setting up the McIntyre dude and Edge at WrestleMania, but then he lost the title, so it's like, oh, how's he going to get it back? Yeah.
Seize the cannons and ballistae! Wear the beast down!
Yeah, this is better.
If you've been wounded, retreat to the rear camp!
Not even sure I know what to do.
Now, now!
Okay, text taken. Oh, okay.
Hold nothing back!
That's right, effing NPC. There should be a thing on the screen that says what all the buttons do. There we go. That's weird, it doesn't have the thing on automated efficiency.
Now, hammer it with all you've got! We need to wear it down!
Yeah.
you haven't paid attention to like any of the story at all, stuff, and all the pictures have been talking to you. For a second, I thought that was wrong in this. Where'd you go? We can both load this at the same time. That's different. Yeah. He's gonna hold five, you blooper.
What's the target's condition?
He's still not weak enough to capture, sir. It shows it on the map. Just don't know how to like, see it.
Okay. Also, when they gave that rapper dude 24/7, though, have they ever done that before where it's like they gave a celebrity a title for publicity? Graphics. This is weird. I would have thought I would remember hitting the core on top of. I mean, I remember like climbing on it like this because this is the only way you fight it, but I don't remember the specific part of the core on the head thing. Like, if you only hit it once and it breaks, so maybe that's not good. This time. I wonder if it's gonna be the same where the incantation was like. Why didn't it check the thingy?
Okay.
Yeah, what? Oh, that might be it. You destroy it, though.
Okay.
also, that's what I was gonna say is when I was watching the Royal Rumbles, and it had like Gold Dust, and then like the other Rhodes brother, but then like a couple years later, he was Stardust. Is that basically like the same gimmick, but like different? Waiting for it to get to the second barrier, apparently.
Shot binders. Oh no! Hunters, you need to get up under Zora Magnaros' shell right now!
A monster! Some unknown monster has appeared on Zora Magnaros' shell!
Ballista team, get ready to provide support! Hunters, under Zora's back, now!
Ballista team, dodge!
Okay, that was weird. I just got like a completion thingy. I'm guessing you're in a cutscene buff, are you? Okay. That's probably what happened to you. I was like, what? Also buff, I don't know if it was like it on the pay-per-view, but like I saw that they had like where they, I guess they still have like the fans on like the weird screen thingies, but then they also have some fans in like the cage thingies or whatever, or like it's, yeah, like I think it's like I think it's all like on the NXT or whatever, but or whatever, but so I was like, oh, they finally have like a bit of a crowd again. What? My own two hands. I haven't made anything in like. Oh.
I mean, I almost did the other morning because my grandparents weren't here, but then I was like, I'm not. It's like, I'm not that hungry. So I was like, no. I knew whatever. I was like, I don't think so. They went to, do their taxes. Do you need anything done? I was trying to see if I have, like, any, like, synergies or something easy. I don't feel like trying either. Just to have a nice, easy final hunt. I don't think I had... Let me check my thingy. I don't think I have the,
Let's see. Yeah, I don't have any of the stuff active in my village right now as far as like the easy stuff that's hard. Oh wait, like look at the... I don't know if you should have been a big quest. Minutes though. Yeah, I haven't done that yet. Oh, we can do this one, and then we're done. Do a nice, easy Zenogeva. Elder Dragon. Have you seen the state of play from today? I was kind of expecting it to be terrible because after like the Nintendo Direct thingy, it kind of was and then the BlizzCon stuff. I mean, I did like the Diablo 2 announcement, but like besides that, it was kind of eh. And then I'm kind of just waiting for the price on the Blizzard Arcade Collection, because, you know, it's interesting, but it's like, I'm not really like a huge fan of video games, so I would just be interested in playing Lost Vikings, because when I played it as a kid, I was very confused because there's so many puzzles I didn't really know how to play. And then Rock and Roll. Racing isn't exactly up there with the Mario Kart for me, so I'm just like, eh. I remember playing it though, but it's just an okay arcade racing game, and then I've never played Bloodborne, so. But then I also have not really heard, like, oh, this game's so amazing, like, standing the test of time, so I don't have high expectations for it. So after those two, I was like, ooh, state of play can go either way, hopefully it's not terrible. And finally they, like, at least have a date on that Kena game I've been looking forward to, so that was nice. That was also like another weird thing is like even though like games they showed I was kind of excited for, they don't have prices, so I'm like, how much are these? I did not. I saw that on my phone, but I didn't know like originally it was supposed to be like a high price release. Yeah, I don't really need anything, or there's nothing coming out really that's like I'm excited for between now and when Mass Effect comes out, so I'm not really worried about the fact that most of the visual is like summer releases. Like it feels good. Yeah, I was kind of expecting there to be more stuff in the first half of the year, but whatever. Nope. Now, like, even though everybody has, like, a digital showcase thing, like Nintendo Direct, I kind of feel like it's a very, like, a hit-or-miss situation of, like, whatever they happen to be playing on that particular character. Well, it just seems like, yeah, I agree. Like, I don't have a problem with it, because it's, you know, like, it's something that's shown that's, like, interested in me. I'm sure, like, at least some people would be happy, but it's also the case of, like, you know, you don't know what they're going to show, so it's, like, hopefully it's something that I'm looking forward to, but there's no guarantee. Since it's not like E3 where they just show everything, it's just, like, selected problems. On like the games you play, like you're probably going to be playing most of the time. If you're into like niche genres and stuff. Some people can never learn to temper their expectations. I mean, I knew they were going to milk it, but I wasn't expecting, like, the egregious, which I should have expected, amount of, like, trying to crop it off. I mean, a mobile battle royale game and, like, another mobile game. Wait, what? That's not even in the scope of a remix that you could just be focusing on, because you're notorious for having projects going into development at all and just taking forever. Now I'm just like, I have no idea when the second part's gonna be done, except like, who knows at this point. They can just keep milking it this badly when you're after the first part's done. I mean, luckily it's a free upgrade, so I'm happy about that. I was surprised, actually. I was not expecting it. Well, I was gonna find it. Yeah, I know it's free, so I'm happy. But the DLC for it isn't free, so. I knew I saw the battery out there. I was like, oh, come on, that is just like, you know. What? I don't know, it's been on this one. It's by whom, and you could have gone to what? Because even though, well, I didn't play them, but like even though the, I guess the reboot or whatever got canceled, EA kind of like reconsidered the whole multiplayer elements of Dragon Age, or what they're not doing right now, or anymore anyway. After Jedi Fallen Order sold a bunch, and then after Heaven was through. Hopefully they're nice, but you can't just shoehorn multiplayer crap on the stuff that doesn't mean. saw something where, like, one game that was, like, announced a while ago, the Vampire Masquerade Bloodlines 2, just indefinitely delayed or something. Oh my gosh, let me carve the monster again. Okay, I'm not able to carve it. Are you able to carve it? Oh, never mind. Yeah. I did too. That was weird. Dagger's playing the Outriders demo. And then everybody else is offline except for Ace Dog, who's playing Call of Duty. So yeah. Well, we can always go back to Fall Guys, because there's a new season that starts next week, or just alternate, so there's always that. Okay. Good night.